Hi everyone, my name is Afreen and I have total 5+ years of experience in data science domain, and so far I have worked with e-commerce, retail and little bit of insurance domain. So I am working as a mentor in Tutor Academy, and today we have Udipto with us, who is working as a data scientist at Zoom. So welcome Udipto, and thank you very much for joining this interview session. Udipto, it will be really great if you could introduce yourself to our viewers about your educational background and your work experience and so on.
Sure. So yeah, first of all, thank you so much for having me, and it's great to be here, and a very good Sunday evening to you all. And so my name is Udipto Datta, as she mentioned, and so I'm currently working as a data scientist in Zoom Video Communications. And before this, I worked in Walmart Global Tech as a data scientist for about 3 years. So overall, I have about nearly 4 years of experience now as a data scientist. I've done internships in ANZ and Cummins Incorporated as well, so which are in the banking and manufacturing sectors respectively. And apart from that, I have worked, so I started out my career in TCS Kolkata, so working as a software engineer, and eventually I ventured into the world of data science. But so I've done my bachelor's in electronics and communication engineering from Techno India Salt Lake, and I've done my master's in quality, reliability and operations research from Indian Statistical Institute Kolkata. So that's how I got my opportunity in Walmart, as I mentioned. So I started out in software engineering, but then I ventured into the field of data science. And it's been a journey full of like a lot of knowledge and a lot of learning. And it's great to be, you know, able to share some of that experience with you guys. So that's where I am.
So Udipto, it's like really a great educational background you have, I must say. So Udipto, what is your roles and responsibility in your current company?
Yeah, so currently I'm working in Zoom, as I mentioned, as a data scientist, but you know, it's just not, the role does not include only, I guess, data modeling related activities. So this role is the projects that I work on are completely like end to end. So I have to start with extracting the data and then trying to gain insights from the data and hopefully make, you know, meaningful conclusions from the data. So the team I mainly work on, I think you can see a tab at the bottom, it's called apps. So like that's the team that I currently work on. So Zoom apps is a team I'm currently assisting. Though there are no particular teams that, you know, it's the role that I have here is not just limited to this particular team. Like everyone here at Zoom, we help out each and every other person in any way possible. So I try to contribute in any way possible to the other teams as well, but I'm primarily associated with this team. And as I said, so my job is to try and pull the data that is necessary to gain meaningful insights for the Zoom apps part of the product, and hopefully, you know, help this particular product grow and hopefully make this company grow and eventually learn and grow as a part of this company as well. So that's pretty much what my experience is in Zoom has been, and it's been a very positive experience, I must say. It's been fantastic.
So if I'm not wrong, you are like working in end-to-end project, like starting from data pulling, data gathering, data cleaning, EDA, and then model building, and then deployment as well, right?
Absolutely.
And then maintenance also after that.
Absolutely, yeah.
Oh, great, nice. So Udipto, like as you said, you have been working in data science domain. So did you get the chance from the beginning? Like, did you make any career transition, or it was from the beginning you were there working in a data science domain?
Yeah. Also, as I mentioned, like I began my career as a software engineer after having completed my BTech in electronics and communication engineering. So I made, I guess, two transitions. So I did my bachelor's in electronics and communication engineering, so which is not software engineering, but then I got an opportunity as a software engineer, so which is different from what I mainly did my bachelor's in. But then my primary intention or my primary interest was always in mathematics and statistics. So I always wanted to do something that's associated with the application of maths and stats in real life problems. So that's where my primary interest always was in. So I was preparing for this exam that I appeared for to get into this particular course that I mentioned that I have done from ISI Kolkata. And you know, after I got the opportunity in ISI, so I was able to learn the basics and the necessary I guess able to gain the necessary knowledge and hopefully the expertise that was needed to venture into the field of data science. But from college, like while I was in Kolkata, I got this opportunity to, you know, do my internships in ANZ and Cummins Incorporated, which are like two different sectors, but both of those were in data science related roles. And eventually got my placement in Walmart Global Tech as a full-time data scientist. So that's how I got this break into this field.
Okay. So Udipta, as you said that you have made a transition from ECE to software engineering, then from there to data science. So I think you are the perfect person to answer this question. Is data science for all? Like, who can learn data science?
Yeah, so I wouldn't say data science is for everybody, because I think I truly believe that it's not only true for data science, because if you take any sort of field, whether it's data science or whether it's like literature or whether it's like physics or chemistry, anything that you want to build your career in, there will always be some people who absolutely love it, are very passionate about it, and there will always be some people who are not so passionate about it, not so keen on it. So we will always have two contrasting opinions, I guess, because the interest for one person is not exactly like equal to the interest of some other person as well. So it definitely varies from person to person. But for a general rule of thumb, if there could be a general rule of thumb, I would say that if you are very passionate about mathematics or statistics or to a little extent about programming as well, I think, because data science would be a very good career path for you, because I think there is application for maths and stats, definitely programming, because whatever you eventually think of or whatever you eventually sort of bring up in your mind, you'll have to implement it using your coding expertise. So all of these things have a role to play in data science. So if you have interest in any of these fields, I would say this is definitely a great place to be in. So because that's how I started with, and I think that's how everybody can actually find the pathway into data science.
So if I summarize this thing, if you have little bit of interest in programming and you have interest in mathematics and statistics, then I think they are good to go for data science domain or data science course.
Yes, I think they will find it more interesting than maybe someone who is interested in some, let's say, other things. But those people will definitely find it much more intriguing and a great career path to go if they are actually passionate about it.
So Udipta, what will be your suggestion to the aspiring data scientists, especially people from electrical and mechanical background? Because whenever they hear about the term programming, they are very scared about it because they are from non-programming background. So if you can elaborate the fact how much programming is required for this particular data science domain or data science course, then it will be clearer to them as well. It will be helpful.
Sure. So I can definitely speak from personal experience, because I am from an electronics and communication engineering background. So the amount of programming that we learned while we were doing our electronics, our EC course, it was not that much. We had programming in one or two semesters, but it was nothing compared to what computer engineers or
what computer science students
or like IT students they learn. So that's definitely not, a detriment to building a career in data science, because the most important thing in data science is to be able, because you need that basic level of programming knowledge so that you can actually implement whatever you are thinking of, as I mentioned, that whatever you have. Whatever your concept is, whatever solution you're thinking of building, so you just need to be able to implement it. That's pretty much it. And implementing that does not require too much intensive coding. It's just you need to have basic knowledge of for loops and like typical stuff like that. So like loops and how to write basic programming, so that you can just put it all together and eventually be able to deploy it as an API or a solution that can be used end to end. So no, definitely the coding is not, the coding that we use here is not too intensive, but SQL is something that will be very important, because,
I agree.
Absolutely, because part of being a data scientist is being able to get the data that you need to build the solutions. So
often they just ignore SQL. That is a very big mistake.
Yes, it's a very big mistake. I would personally suggest that, because once again, like I'm from ECE background, we did not have like specific courses on SQL, which we learned during our time in, while doing our ECE background. So doing our ECE course. But yeah, so that I definitely have to learn separately. And I think everybody has to do it, because as I said, so being a data science professional, of course, you have data engineers whose roles are slightly different and more aligned to, the I guess the application of SQL. But being a data scientist, you cannot rely on someone else to give you the data all the time to be able to build those insights that you are actually looking to build.
Because so, verification has to be done from our end, whether the data we have collected is correct or not.
Definitely. And of course, there are like with every different problem, you will need like a different set of data, or even a particular set of data that you have been given might not be sufficient for you to build the solution that you're actually looking to build. So that is actually very important. So for in terms of programming, I wouldn't say that you will need to be an expert level programmer to be able to get into data science, but at least an intermediate knowledge, as I said, beginner to intermediate knowledge for building like basic programs, because you will eventually need to deploy that solution that you are building. That needs to be there. So that could just take a little more effort than, you know, overall the data science learning activity would take. So if you like, let's say, take around 6 to 8 months to learn the basics of data science, you might need, let's say, 2 to 3 months more to learn the basics of programming as well. So if that should be sufficient, but yeah, we should definitely stress more on SQL compared to other programming techniques if you want to have a career in data science. So that's my opinion.
Yes, that's a very correct answer, I would say. And I think now mechanical and electrical students, those who are aspiring to be a data scientist, they can be very happy. I mean, I think they'll be very happy after hearing that, because you don't need to be a master of programming. Like, you don't need to know hierarchy. I mean, inheritance, encapsulation, and all these things are not required. Basic logic building capability should be there, which you must earn. And your SQL should be very strong. That should be very, very strong, right? So, Udipto, do you take interviews also for data science role?
Yes, I have taken interviews in the past. I've interviewed in IIT Kharagpur for freshers. And yes, it was a good experience for me as well. I hope for the candidates as well.
So then I think you are a perfect person to answer this question as well. Like, what should the candidates focus more? They should focus on their certification, or they should focus on their knowledge or their domain expertise, real-time projects while learning data science?
Yes,
what would be your suggestion?
Definitely. When I was actually reviewing some of the CVs, that some of the resumes that I got for the potential candidates for the role that I was interviewing for, I was taking interviews for, I saw that most of the resumes they had a lot of certifications that they have done, or a lot of, I would say, buzzwords. Like, let's say I've worked on like LSTM, I've worked on neural networks, I've worked on like, let's say, ARIMA or something, like it could be any algorithm you can put into there. So I saw a lot of buzzwords there. But when I asked a few questions from those particular projects that they worked on and how they've applied those algorithms, some of them are not able to answer, I guess, appropriately. So what this tells us is essentially certificates and, you know, just being, just knowing the absolute, I guess, from the very top of it, or I guess learning the, let's say, on a very high level, is not actually ideal when you're actually wanting to implement that in your role, or implement that in the project that you're actually doing. Because any project that we're working on, or any solution that we are building for the stakeholders, it will come with a set of challenges. When you're working on it, we'll face some challenges. Just implementing an algorithm, which we can, you know, thanks to the, I guess, many packages that were available in R and Python, we can easily implement any solution that we can find on the internet. If we just look for a particular problem and just the particular algorithm that can help in solving that problem, that can easily be done. But what is more important is that when we face those roadblocks, and if we face those roadblocks, whether we are able to identify the reason behind why we are having that problem, and we are able to solve it on the go. So in order to do that, a certification is not, it cannot really help in that regard. So what we need is to have the depth of knowledge and the understanding as to why we are applying a particular algorithm in a particular situation. Because one algorithm will work well in some situation, and will definitely not work in the same capacity in some other situations. So having the depth of knowledge is very important, and how to apply what and when to apply what and why to apply that particular thing in certain situations is the most important criterion that I personally focus on when I'm looking for some candidates for my organization. So.
Okay. So like, it will be like, if you're doing 2 or 3 projects, that is fine, but do it completely. Like, end-to-end project should be done. And if you're mentioning 3-4 algorithms, that is also fine, but you should know the mathematical intuition behind it, and all the what, when, and why questions, like why I'm applying, what is the problem statement? That is very important to understand the problem statement. What kind of problem statement that algorithm can be used?
Definitely.
Right. So that is.
And to what extent the problem, the algorithm, or the approach that the candidate or the person took was able to solve that particular business problem? Because at the end of the day, it all boils down to whether you were able to solve that problem and to what extent you were able to solve that problem. So if that solution was, if that approach was able to solve your problem, that should be good enough. So that understanding, if it's there, and if you have the sufficient expertise, sufficient experience of building end-to-end solutions, just like you mentioned, I think that will hold you in much higher regard than having a few more certificates.
Udipto, like already we have discussed about how much programming is required for data science, right? Now, if you can elaborate how much math is required for data science, because there are people like I have been asked, I mean, so many people have asked me this question, like my math background is very weak. How would I survive in this particular domain and so on? So how much math is required and can it be learned or something like that? So in terms of mathematics, if you can elaborate.
Definitely. So as I said, so maths and stats are the basics of, I guess it's at the, I think it's like if you're building a cake and the solution that we're actually building is actually the icing on top of the cake. So maths and stats is pretty much the layer of the cake, the underlying layers of the cake. So that's pretty much how I look at it. So if you want to understand the reasoning behind it or actually the logic behind a particular solution that you're implementing, so it's quite important to know maths and statistics because you'll be able to understand it in much more detail as to like why you are implementing that particular solution. So that can definitely help in that regard, and it does help, as I've seen from my experience, and I'm sure you have seen from your experience as well. And if someone who is not so keen on maths is wanting to get into this field, then I would suggest that the maths that is needed for this is not too intensive. You don't need to start a maths course from the very beginning and then eventually get into it. I don't think that's what's needed. But there are certain things in maths, like let's say some basic integrations or like some basic differentiations, because which are like almost the, I guess that's the basis of any kind of activities in data science that we'll be doing, whether it's like gradient descent or whether it's like as I said, area under the curve or like anything that you're doing. So if you have some basic knowledge of certain basic things, which I believe everyone who has, of course, gone through school will have learned while they were in school, like as a part of their maths programs that they had in the school. So that's not something that's like too out of the ordinary that is needed. So that can definitely be something that can be picked up quite quickly. I would say I would actually think that can be learned quite much more quicker than programming. So because programming is something that you need to like practice and get into it a lot more, but maths is sort of concept which you can definitely learn in a much quicker time. And yeah, so once we are able to get into it, I think whatever solutions you are building will actually be more enthusiastic about it because you'll understand the nitty-gritties behind it and you'll actually get into it much more than you originally would have if you had skipped the maths part and just gone straight ahead into the solution.
So if I summarize the points, like data science is for those who are coming from especially those who are coming from an engineering background, because they must have done mathematics and they must have the knowledge of physics. So I think programming can be learned. If not, it will take some time. Like logic building can be learned, programming can be learned. So those who are very new to this programming field, they can learn it. But for them, it will take a little bit longer time than the people who already have exposed to this programming field. Right? Yeah, and mathematics and people from mathematics and science background also, they can come in data science domain, right? Because the fundamental is maths and statistics. Absolutely. Physics part. So if they are coming from that particular domain, then it is good, like they can learn programming
without
in future.
Absolutely, without a doubt.
Yeah. Udipta, how many rounds of interviews you face for your role in Zoom?
So I went through like 4 rounds in total. So like the first round was on data science basics as to like some of the things that in data science that I have done in my previous organizations. And another round was a coding based round. But as I mentioned previously as well, the coding was mostly on SQL. So because SQL plays a huge role in the in my current organization and the kind of role that I am currently working in. So These were the first two rounds, and the next two rounds were mostly like, I guess, compatibility tests for the particular role. So like, you know, I guess I was mostly asked questions on, so mostly some puzzles sort of questions, like whether I can, so it just, I guess it was to test whether I can think on the fly or not, whether I'm able to, how much I'm able to improvise on the spot regarding certain situations. And of course, like I was asked about the different, you know, business scenarios that I might potentially face, how, what would be my approach in those situations. And
In short word, your analytical acumen, they were testing.
Yes. So the first round, as I said, was completely technical background, one technical standpoint from a data science basics background, and the next one was coding rounds, and the last two rounds were like, you know, role compatibility rounds from the from business perspective, mostly from business perspective.
So with this, we have come to the end of this interview session, and the last question I would like to ask you, Udipta, is what will be your some suggestions, some tips and tricks to the aspiring data scientists? I know you have answered all our questions, but at last, few final mantra, if you can give us.
Sure. So like, as I mentioned, so we all have to start somewhere. I also started as a software engineer, and then eventually ventured into the world of data science. And of course, it's a vast world, and we have to start learning somewhere. And I believe if you want to get started with it, there are two major pathways that you can probably look at. One would be that, like the path that I followed, that I paused my career for a couple of years, and I did my master's in applied statistics, and then eventually I got my break in data science. So that's how I ventured into it. But if you're not willing to do that, then I would say you can actually keep your career going and at the same time start learning, because there are so many free courses available on the internet from where you can learn the basics. And of course, because then you have to just, you know, put in your time and effort and to figure out like what suits you best and what can actually help you learn the most if you want to become a data science professional. But of course, if you're looking for an organized, structured course that can actually help you get your career started in data science and make a successful transition into the world of data science, I would suggest some course like Tutored Academy, because I've seen through, been involved in some of the coursework that they have created. And I think there'll be some wonderful work there. And the guidance that the Tutored Academy is offering is going to be very beneficial for everyone who is venturing into this field of data science without having to pause their careers and, you know, learn it explicitly from some institution, like which I did. Yes, I enjoyed my experience, but I think this experience can also be very beneficial, and it will actually help you learn two things at the same time and eventually create a successful career in data science as well. So that's how I think would be the best possible way to go. And of course, there are a lot of things, there are a lot of ways to have fun in data science as well. We have, I personally got acquainted with it when I watched the movie Moneyball. I started Brad Pitt, and it showed that how you can use data science and numbers and actually make a underperforming sports team, a baseball team, into actually a very well-performing team. So yeah, I think that's just one example of how you can use data science in different areas. So there are a lot of opportunities to have fun. Of course, all we need to do is have this, keep up this desire to learn every single day, because there are a lot of things happening in data science and we just need to keep up with it. But if you are interested, if you're passionate about it, I think there are a lot of ways we can learn it, and we can definitely have a successful career in data science if we do this. So, sure.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Udipta. I think your answers have shown us a very clear path, and especially them who were scared for programming, who were thinking a lot about programming. So you have shown us two ways to learn data science, either by pausing my career, or if I choose not to pause my career, there are several resources from where we can learn. Thank you so much for your valuable suggestions and your experience. And with that, I will end up this session. Thank you for joining us today, Udipta.
Thanks for having me. Thank you so much.